So the examiner is not going to look at the question paper. You can plan your structure of the essay in the question paper itself. So always structure it before, then write. Hello everyone, welcome to the part 2 of the IELTS preparation series. And if you haven't watched the part 1, you can watch it right here. I will put the link here. And welcome to the second part of the IELTS writing section, where I will be talking to you about tips and tricks on how to crack the IELTS writing section. So let us get started. Number one tip is, do not like waste more than 20 minutes on task 1. As you know that there are two tasks in the writing section, task 1 and task 2, and you only need around 20 minutes for the task 1 because you need to focus on the task 2, which carries more weightage than the task 1. So do not spend more than 20 minutes on the task 1. Number two is word limit. Always write 150 words for task 1 and 250 words for task 2. And this is a recommendation, and you can write less or more than that. But if they have given a certain like not more than these many words, so do not write more than that words, because they will cut marks for each and every word. Each and every word more you write from the space given. Number three is, you can plan your essay on the question paper itself. So the examiner is not going to look at the question paper. You can plan your structure of the essay in the question paper itself. So always structure it before, then write it. Follow this always. The next step is, always cover all the points. For example, the task one is usually a bar graph or a pie chart given. So always cover each and every point. And for example, a pie chart is given and there are 10 like distributions in a pie chart. So always cover all the 10 distributions. You have to write about all of them. Do not miss even a single thing. Just write as many details as you can infer from the bar chart or the pie graph which is given to you. The next tip I can give you right now is, like, always structure a paragraph. You have to follow the basic structure, right? After I see the topic of the paragraph, what I will do is, I will get to my question paper. I will write what I'm going to write about here. I will write the main points there. And I will write, basic structure is, for example, overview, then two body sections and the conclusion. Do not miss the conclusion, even if you have like a minute or half. So always write the conclusion, because it closes your paragraph and it looks a bit structured. Next tip I can give you right now is, always check the spellings. So there is no autocorrect in the writing section, right? And you have to always check the spellings, because they will not also tell you the red thing which comes in the word when you write a wrong answer. So they will not tell you that you have written a wrong word or the spelling is incorrect. You have to find it on your own. So always check the spellings, because spellings are the main part where the marks get cut in the writing section. Next thing is, keep all the information relevant and consistent. Like, more does not mean that you will be getting more marks. So you have to be consistent with the information you are putting in there. You have to be precise, you have to be related to the topic, and you have to follow a basic structure for writing the paragraph. Do not focus on writing more words, focus on writing more value. The next thing you should know about the how you are graded, like how do you get marks in the writing section. So in the writing section, you are graded in four parts. Number one is task response. Number two is coherence and cohesion. Number three is grammar. And number four is vocabulary. Each of these carry equal weightage, and which is 25% of your, like 25%, 25%. So it gives you a total weightage of 100%. So if you do not know what is coherence and cohesion, you can check out my video of the IELTS, which I have uploaded on my YouTube channel. And I will put the link in the description. The last tip which I will be giving right now is, practice as many more passages in writing as you can. So writing section is a bit easier to write, but it is also hard to get the marks in the writing section. People usually get very less marks in the writing section, because it is very strict. Like, it is strict on the basis of words which you have write. For example, if they are saying 250 words, you have written 251, marks will be cut. If you have made a grammatical mistake, then marks will be cut. And if you have not followed the basic structure of the paragraph, then also marks will be cut. So it is a bit tough to get marks in the writing section, but if you follow each and every tip, then I am sure you will be able to get good marks in the writing section. So yeah. So this is it for the video, guys. This was the part 2 of the IELTS preparation series, and if you haven't watched the part 1, I will be putting the link in the description below. So in the next part, I will be talking about IELTS listening part, like how you can master your IELTS listening and the tips and tricks on how to like approach the listening section. So let us meet in the next video, aur is video ke liye itna hi, milte hain next video mein. Bye bye.
So you wanna be my enemy? You should've known I'd never kiss the rain. Ice runs in